sometimes Saba needs us and other times we need Saba. And I think going home, it's always that, like, I needed Saba. No matter what I came in the week looking like and whatever I did on the island to change, I think going back, like, the Sabans have just always instilled this, like, heart that I have to give in the way that I treat others and look at others.
God knew what he was doing from day one. From the first time we stepped on the island, God knew what he was doing. And it just continues.
It's beautiful.
It's indescribable.
It's the unspoiled queen.
When you get off the plane the first time, it's like, it's, you know, there's no words for it. You just, it's just incredible. And the whole trip was that, you know. And so for everybody, which was really neat that all of us got to kind of do that together.
Get to the island, and I'm not exaggerating, the first day we're driving from the airport to where we were staying to the bottom, and a friend of mine, Julius, leans out of his Saba electric truck and he says, "Welcome home, my friend." And when he said that day in 2004, I thought, I will always be that kid.
When I went to the airport to pick Michael up, and I had been down. I was so excited to be expecting Jackson, but I've been so down because I wanted to be back here so much. And the first thing that they showed me, they had videoed this, but the Sacred Heart, Saba Comprehensive kids had all gotten together, and a group of the boys that I taught had them video them at a school assembly, and they sang, Miss Thomas went over the ocean. Miss Thomas went over the sea. Miss Thomas went over the ocean. Oh, bring back Miss Thomas to me.
The first time that I went, I was just an itty-bitty freshman going into my sophomore year, and I was still kind of confused as to what I wanted to do with my life. And then I returned that following spring break and actually found out that I didn't get into nursing school. It was devastating because I thought I wanted to do it since I was in seventh grade. But then through the Lord and through His grace and just the teammates that I had and the people of Saba, I was able to find my passion for social work.
I've been blessed to have a lot of different opportunities, go to a lot of different places, and see God working in a lot of different people's lives, you know, whether that be children or adults or different areas, and that's been just such a blessing. But, you know, I've loved, and that's something I love to do is with short-term missions, is kind of return back to places, and Saba is definitely one of those places. It's my third trip. But just being able to come back and, you know, pour into these kids' lives that, you know, that you really have gotten close with. And the coolest thing is, like, when you come back and they remember your name and they say, "Luke," you know, and you're like, "Wow, you remember me. I didn't expect for all you to remember me."
I've just got done playing with a few of the kindergartners, and that has been a blast in there. And they're just pegging people with balls in there and running away playing tag. So already just, you know, little things like that. But the deeper conversation we'll be able to have with the secondary school is going to definitely be one of the more impactful moments of this trip, I believe.
The last spring break I was on, so about a year ago,
Whenever I spoke, it was a really hard time for me. I was crying, but like those girls like came up to me afterwards and like related, and to me like that's worth it, just to be able to like universal, like so many struggles are universal, and just to like have that here with those people and make connections, like that was a definitive Saba moment for me.
One of the biggest things that I take from or what I've learned from them and that I always take home is just like the joy that they have from little things. Like they get really excited about dodgeball or playing basketball or just like holding somebody's hand.
The kids are like number one for me, and but also along with them is how supportive their parents have been throughout the years, and they come up to us and welcome us back every year, and they are thankful for the time that we spend with their kids and how we put so much effort into it.
You fall in love with the people and you can't stop. I mean, it's impossible. I mean, for us, it was impossible to stop.
First year I was here, we had a baptism down in Cove Bay at the ocean, and that made it all worth it, I felt like. That was the culmination of years and years of this trip kind of working together, and a lot of people who were there and a lot of people who weren't there. And so it kind of made it all meaningful, it seemed like.
I'm a lot more interactive with people, and I'm not scared to share. I'm not shy, I'm not timid about my faith. I open up to people a lot more now than I used to.
I think it impacts me to be more like a kid, with the mindset at least. You know, that's how God says we should act. We should act like the kids. So just be more willing to do stuff, because when you ask kids a question here and when you ask them to do things, they are on board with it and they do not second guess it.
We are here and we leave, and I think there's a sadness and a separation to that, but we come back, and I think them like knowing that it's really joyful for them, and it's definitely joyful for us to say, hey, I'm gonna see you again like in 6 months. We are able to better build those relationships, and that's really cool to see.
I remember the first time I was there, they were like, teacher, why are you here? And I was like, to spend time with you and get to see your beautiful island. I think of all of them and how I've seen them grow up and mature, and from me having to almost wrestle them to the ground just to get them to listen to me, to now them asking questions about how they can be saved and how they can further the kingdom.
On this island, I've found like a peace that I haven't found in so long. And that's just like seeing the smiles on the kids' faces and like hearing their stories, like sitting in the back of the bus and talking to a little boy named Greco and just like telling me about like how he's been to Columbia, how he wants to go to a 21 Pilots concert and stuff like that. And it's just like that connection is like why I've already fallen in love with this place.
The family that I make from Lipscomb and the family that I have on Saba, it's just a beautiful thing to see them come together. Of course, I could name you off like 20,000 children that have made an impact on my life, or the principals or the teachers or whoever it may be on the island, as well as all the former teammates. But I keep going back because I feel like God needs me there, and I feel like there's Sabans that need me as well as I need the Sabans.
I consider this to be a second home for us. I'd consider that, but to know the people here see us as theirs and have welcomed our children in that way means the world to me. When Jackson did come back, Jackson was loved on, and the same for Nancy Caroline and Sadie. The teachers here will tell me they're Saban. Like when they're here, they're like they see them do things and they say Saba lives in them. They're Saban children.
What is your most favorite part about spending time on Saba?
My favorite part about spending time on Saba is getting to build new relationships with people and getting to just experience sort of the Saba life.
playing with the kids and seeing how they smile so much because they're so excited that we're here.
So this is like a second home to me now. So, like just seeing like the people I know and seeing the new people that like and just hanging out with like the new people on the trip of our team.
The reason why I'm coming back is these kids and just loving on them and pouring into them and just seeing how the Lord is working on this island is just so encouraging.
A bunch of us went up to the top of Whale's Head and just sitting up there and looking down at the bottom and just being able to see the whole like majority of the island and looking out over the ocean and just seeing the beauty of what God had created just makes you fall in love again with the power that is God and what he has to offer to us.
Saba helped strengthen my spiritual life in prayer and everything over the past year, and I always reflect to Saba because every day on my laptop I have Saba as my background, and I look there and I just always smile every time I open my computer.
The beauty of the place, how easy it is to see God, not only in the physical beauty, but in the people, and to experience God in a place like that. When you see that and you experience that and you're a part of that, it changes you.
I know I only spend 24-ish days out of the year there, but it's so much more than that. It's the Facebook messages, it's the WhatsApp app, it's the relationships. I mean, Aletha and Michael have made it intentional to create relationships and to form bonds that last more than those 24 days. And so when I think of Saba, I don't ever think short-term missions. I think of it as a connection between Lipscomb and Saba.
John and I both really have a heart for like long-term missions, and that's something we really want to do. And when we, like, before I came here, John was like, I really think I want to do that in Saba. And I was like, I don't know. It's hot there all the time. But, like, after actually being here for, you know, 3 years now, I think we both really wanted to pour into that.
The Sabans who have affected this trip and impacted this trip, continually hosting us year to year, helping us arrange details and organize events and welcoming us into their homes, has strengthened this trip more than I can say.
You guys are helping us mold our kids and you're loving on our island. And I couldn't thank the Lipscomb students enough for that. They're a huge part of my heart.